live at your mom's house.
Uh-oh. Do we have sound? Red, switch the sound over.
Heading down with SRB. Don't even bother looking for me when I don't wear the sand to see. Heading down there to 38. Maybe stop by a valley. Have a drink and some breezy food. Well, I don't care what you want, still hanging here from 38. Yeah, the Key West is kind of nice. Actually been there once or twice. Well, if you ask me is what I'd say, I'd rather stay with you on 38. Maybe drive over to Destin. See all those tourists that decompressing. Well, maybe it's just for the best if I stay in on 38. Got a girl over near my beach. She's kind of weird, but she's super sweet. Well, I like it when she wants to meet down here.
Why do we cut that song off? It's such a great song. We always cut it off.
I don't know. Read it the blank part?
Yeah.
Well, hello.
We need
more stuff. Hey, guys, welcome to the show. It's Nothing Scripted. I am your Uncle Wes. Show about anything, everything, and nothing all at the same time. Uh-huh. Joined by my friends, Paul and Lieutenant Paula.
Ah.
Yeah. So,
Lieutenant Dave.
Yeah.
This is our special coronavirus episode tonight. And yes, exactly. Exactly. Hopefully everybody has their toilet paper.
Yeah. War eagle.
War damn eagle. Yes, that's right.
What does that even have to do with the coronavirus?
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's not saying our minds.
But anyway.
It doesn't make you poop, right? I mean.
No, it doesn't. That's not a symptom.
It's not the point.
And if you're hurting, if you get quarantined for 14 days at the house, and you don't have 14 days worth of TP, take a damn shower.
Right, shower down.
Ew, I'm not doing that.
Go out in the backyard with a water hose and squirt your undercarriage down.
No, it's different pipes.
Yeah.
You can't do that. It's different pipes.
You can clean your transmission a different way.
You never used a bidet?
Yeah.
Well, doesn't that clean?
Different pipes.
What do you mean?
A bidet is not in your toilet.
Where the hell is it?
Next to it.
Oh, yes.
Oh, so you stand over next to your toilet while you... Use a bidet?
Different pipes.
I don't think that's the way it works.
I am not putting that down
my
pipes.
Well, now they have ones you can adapt to your toilet.
Yeah, yes, they do.
When you wear Jim and Robin, when you need on the...
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yes. So anyway, guys, thanks so much in advance for sharing the broadcast with your friends.
That's what I'm doing.
Hopefully you're not ashamed of us. And, you know, we've got our Irish gear because St. Paddy's Day, Corona-ish. St. Paddy's Day is going to happen before our next show, so we figured we'd go ahead and do some St. Paddy's Day stuff tonight.
We taste this bagar be Christ.
We
that okay.
We God bless you.
Yeah. He's got the Corona Irish. That's what's going on. But anyway, we have some sponsors, believe it or not.
What?
Yeah. Yeah. First sponsor would be...
I'm trying to give it up now.
That one thing that it does the therapy.
You.
Yeah.
I forgot all about it.
Thanks. Yeah.
That's
me. Loving Pops. Yes.
We're coming back soon.
All right.
Better and stronger now.
You buying new sticks?
I got sticks.
Score.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good start.
I'm still sharing.
And a Frigidaire?
Yes.
You got a Frigidaire?
We got all that stuff.
Sweet.
Yep.
Yeah.
I know. I'm sharing it too. Thanks for sharing it.
Who else we got a sponsor?
Well, there's the... Modern Air.
Modern Air.
Just wanted to make sure it came up first.
There, you're going to need that pretty soon. We're getting some weather.
I was talking about Stacy just a couple of days ago.
She's awesome.
She's great.
Her name came up with the Gulf Coast Jam and the Sun Jam.
Stacy is like the sweetest person, man. I tell you, I've stopped by to see them a couple of times.
Adorbs.
She gives a big hug and invites me into place, and they just stop work.
If you say adorbs.
And hang out with me for a few minutes.
Ever again, I'm going to punch you.
Do
I'm just putting out there.
Did you say adorbs?
He said adorbs.
That's because he's drinking White Claw.
It's not a tiny news.
He
has that's actual vodka soda.
He has a vagina.
Let's talk this woman to woman.
Hey, we have that newest sponsor this week.
Oh, yeah, the newest sponsor. Hey, who would that be? Trailer Trash Mercantile. Hey, if you like the camp, you like the RV life, you go out and go to trailertrashmercantile.com. and get you some apparel, man. That's pretty cool stuff.
It just goes if I do say so.
Did you get put in front of the on the beach and
I didn't set up this
place. Yes.
What order are they in, John?
We have some priorities.
Oh, the beach is next.
Yeah. Okay, just wanted to make sure which one.
Same order they've always been. We replaced.
Oh.
Another sponsor
we're
with Trailer Trash Marketing.
I'm following. Yep.
So the next sponsor is the Own It the Beach team. Hey, if you're looking to sell or buy real estate around the Sandestin, South Walton area, these ladies are where you need to go.
She's adorbs.
Look, you can't throw a rock without hitting a realtor down here, but if you throw a rock at this team, I'm going to be upset with you because they're super sweet ladies.
They really are.
Listen, if you can't take the time to say adorable, you are just so pressed for time. He said it again.
I watch a lot of Rachel Ray since I've been drinking this stuff.
Yeah.
EVOO.
Probably.
Her EVOO.
And her new.
You're just too busy to say the whole sentence.
Her new trash.
Yep.
Oh, Lord.
And then, of course, Conn's Furniture is a sponsor as well.
Fine Furniture.
Fine Furniture.
Oh, no, that's the other one.
No, that's the other one.
Oh, hell.
Her furniture is fine as well.
I
mean,
good chair.
Yes.
Go buy a table.
If you need a table or a vase.
Or that Prince painting that I want.
Right, or the Catherine Audrey Hepburn.
I want that Prince one right there.
Which one?
Mm. See him?
Oh, is that Prince or Weird Al?
I thought that was Charlie Chaplin.
You just ruined the face. No, I don't want it anymore.
It's Weird Al.
it's
Weird Al.
What do we have next?
I forget.
Well,
your bit.
You know what? We choose a hydration word every week, and then we drag trash cans through the restaurant, and
I thought there was
you know thunder. Really loudly with you know. We ought to have some midgets wrestling in the back there and jumping off tables too, with jingle bells on their feet. That's what we should do, just to make it a little louder. So anyway, every week when Paula's with us, and unfortunately she's had a lot going on the last few weeks.
Been a little busy.
And that's cool. And we still love her. Tending to your llama.
I've been tending to my llama.
There you go.
I found a llama in the parking lot next door.
That's right. And what did we name him?
Tony.
Yeah, Tony Llama.
Tony Llama.
Tony Llama.
Tony
Llama.
Not after Tony.
Oh, I'm long
in the audience.
Person.
Yeah.
But I was going to use llama because I did find him ironically right before I walked here, but I chose Bubbles instead so that we have some pink bubbles for Jameson and Tracy.
All right. Yeah. So that is the hydration word.
Hydration word is bubbles.
The rule is anytime you hear the term bubbles, you're required by the International Coronavirus Treaty to take a drink of your tasty beverage.
Does Red have the donation can handy by any chance?
Helen. She's busy dragging trash cans right now.
We suggest that she might do that and come talk about it.
I think Kelly's on it. We're going to put a donation, but you can find those donation jars everywhere
we can't see
around
that.
Town.
They can't see that.
I'm trying.
You'll see it here in a minute. We'll get
so they're really cool looking jars. They're large mason jar type things like I used to drink moonshine out of. And I'm not talking about the shit you can buy in Gatlinburg at any liquor store. I'm talking about real moonshine.
That was a gallon jar.
Yeah, the gallon looking mason jars. We used to drink that, throw it up. And that's probably why I have to wear glasses now. But anyway. Anytime you see those, you put a little cheese in there for our friend Tracy, who had a bad accident. Here we go.
Pay attention.
Yeah, there you go. There's the jar.
There it is.
Got Kelly all over it.
And anybody in the service industry realize, I mean, you know,
it's gonna live.
Health insurance and disability insurance is not really a thing. So, you know, if you see that laying around on our left is Tracy. She's the one that had the bad accident. She broke some vertebrae and ankle and stuff. So be sure to contribute a little bit. Drop a few bucks in there to help them out while she's recuperating.
This is one of the most supportive communities I've ever lived in, and this is the reason why.
There you go.
They also have a bank account set up down here, I think, at, what was it, Centennial? What's the bank that?
Centennial on 393.
Centennial on 393. You can also go there and make a donation and
cool's that?
And,
community bank. Thank you so
much.
Yes,
yes. Okay, our community little bank here. So, and then there's a GoFundMe as well.
Yeah,
you can
we'll post all that stuff.
Yeah, we'll post all that stuff. But, you know, she being in the service industry, which is happens to be what happens a lot around here, we don't get help. They don't get health insurance
right.
with that job. As hard as they work and how much we appreciate them in this town, depends on them. Unfortunately, yep. they don't get health insurance. So yep. help Tracy out if you can, and she's going to need it. She's got a long road ahead of her. So yep. we love her and love so Jameson, and we're here for her.
Best to you gals.
And you better believe it.
Yep.
Here's bubbles. Pink bubbles.
Pink bubbles.
Pink bubbles, too.
See, there you go. Pink cup. See that?
Pink cup. How about that? That's for my girls.
So if you're out of a beverage, now's a great time to go.
What? No, this is the best part.
Because Paul's going to tell some really shitty jokes.
No, this is the best part.
They're terrible.
They're not.
I promise you.
There goes Billy. Billy knows the routine. Yeah.
So now's a good time to go get another beverage. I'm getting out.
Please welcome Michael Bublé.
If you know Paul, you know he's a force of nature. This man stood shoulders to shoulders with my idols, with Frank, with Sammy, and Dean. And I'm sure the stories that he has and doesn't tell you would be bestsellers.
I have to make it even louder now.
All right.
There's the first one.
Yep.
It's a dark room.
Lord help me. Hey, Billy. Thanks for sticking around.
Maybe Red can turn it up a little bit.
Oh, what a good time of year for this.
I can't read it.
Oh, Lord. Tourists. The flies are awfully thick around here. Do you ever shoe them?
No.
Nope. We just let them go barefoot.
No.
Oh, shoot. I can hear that plane again, John.
Nice.
Oh, it's on his on her phone.
Oh, nice. Hmm?
Go ahead. Two scammers tried to sell me fake glasses, but I saw right through them.
I'm gonna boo. Thank you.
No, booze? That's funny.
No, it's not.
No, it isn't?
Uh-uh.
This is the best one.
I gave you so many jokes.
No, I know, but what about this one?
Where'd you find those toilet rolls? I'll be back.
This is a visual joke. You'll see it on the replay.
Yes, it's Arnold Schwarzenegger holding a big pack of
funny.
Toilet paper. I'll be back.
Where'd you find those toilet rolls? Arnie, I'll
oh,
be.
Oh, God, you've over-explained it. Let's move on before I kill myself.
<That's>... Me, I don't know what a cloning machine does. Her. That makes two of us. Come on, think about it. It's a thinking man's joke.
Like that one.
A cloning machine. Two of us.
Mm-hmm. Red keeps singing sentimental songs in a soft, low voice.
Uh-huh.
I think it's the...
crooner virus.
What's a crooner?
A crooner's like a Frank Sinatra.
Oh, Jesus.
Alfalfa.
Oh.
What's my crooner sing?
Again with the blank?
Yeah,
oh, yeah, it's racist.
Oh,
oh yay. Oh, it went
no.
down. It went down through the jokes. That's tragic.
There it is.
Oh.
Oh, this is...
Cherry Holmes, Rice Friskies,
I
corn
was
flakes.
In... No, you got to explain it.
Captain
Because they
Munch,
can't see it.
Adult cereal
I
aisle.
Was in the store, and there's an aisle that said adult cereals. So I was wondering what the names of them should be. One of them would be Cheerios. Or what about Rice Frisky?
Cornflakes? Captain Munch.
What about Captain Munch?
Are you still telling jokes?
Cornflakes.
It's yeah, no.
This is a really good
no,
one.
No, we're not.
I haven't really started the jokes yet.
Oh, God.
Really?
What?
Are you
no, get dressed. Yeah.
No, I was in the. Didn't you see this one? I was in the adult. Oh, it went away.
Mm-mm.
Thought you were going to
I'm
bring
glad
it, back,
it went
so
away.
Wes could help. No, Wes is going to make some suggestions. Come on. Can we go back one?
All right.
Oh, God.
All right.
Here we go.
What we got? All right.
So,
Cheerios,
see,
Rice Frisky, Corn Flakes, Captain Munch.
What would you call it?
He laughed. Oh, my God.
Captain D?
Yeah. Captain D, you know, special D.
Uh-huh.
Special
D? Yeah.
That's
a good one.
What yeah,
was,
let's
was that
move on.
From the audience?
Special D and the boys.
Special D and the boys. There you go.
They're we'll great.
Lucky.
Frosted Flakes.
Oh.
Wow, there you go. So.
That immediately made me go, ugh.
Mm. Yeah, there you go.
Things that make it go, I'm sure. I'm
Count
sure.
Dracula. Add your suggestions in the comments.
I think they're going to comment.
Okay.
They are. Karen says nothing.
Oh, boy.
She said, good to see our favorite lieutenant. TJ yeah. Mallory, I think you're drinking because he said these are good.
There you go.
So, oh, you
thank
too.
You to our...
Frosted Flakes was the best joke that's happened.
Online audience.
So
bar
gross.
None.
So gross.
This was yeah. for you.
Yes.
Oh, the safe was invented by a cop and a robber.
Mm-hmm.
It was quite the combination.
Holy shit. Oh, terrible.
We only had 22 viewers going into the jokes. Now we're down to 18.
No, but there's going to be more here in a minute.
Yeah, we'll see what happens.
This one's fun.
Was it? Come on, Wes.
Why can't pregnant cows run?
Yeah.
They have no calves.
Jesus. You're not supposed to run. They'll kill anyway.
That's the way I feel about that. That's how I feel about that. Why do ghosts haunt old houses? Because they don't have a life. Because
they don't have a life.
See?
See what? What are we supposed to say?
It's a play on words.
Yeah, well, we understand the joke. It's not that we don't understand. Uh-oh.
Look, you killed the llama.
I think
it's the fact that they suck.
It jumped. That's a long way for a llama to jump.
It jumped up to its death after hearing all the bad jokes.
There's marks here.
By the way, immediately following the show tonight here at Reds, we're having open mic night, and your Uncle Wes is hosting. So if you're a musician and you're not here already, you need
you're
to
late.
Load up and come on.
Should we remind them to put their babies away and stuff?
Yeah, this is not safe at all for kids.
Or old people.
Clearly.
Or old people with sensitive constitutions.
That's why I tell
or
clean jokes.
Somebody
kind of like the coronavirus.
A keyboard and has a sissy pants. Or
yeah.
Any of those
somebody gets butt hurt easily. This is not your show.
Yeah,
not sure.
Frosted Flakes.
Yes.
Not your
show. All right, we're down to 14 now.
All right. Come on back. All right. Just
you got to share it more.
So let's get into the news. I'm going to do a watch party, which means I won't be able to
that's what I'm doing too.
See any of the cops.
Ain't no party like a West watch party.
Coming to you from the beautiful 38 Television Studios on the Nothing Scripted Highway, it's the news.
Give up.
Pop a boner.
We can't say that.
No.
Sure we can.
Oh, come on. Yeah, you
did they already say it? Oh, you
80% chance they heard it. Don't you think? 80% chance they heard it.
Oh, damn it.
Damn it. Oh, okay. So let's get into the news. All right. Before we get all jokey about the coronavirus, we need to go over some stats with you, okay? Currently, there are 95,000 confirmed cases of coronavirus and 3,200 deaths. 51,156 are confirmed recovered individuals.
Mm.
If you prefer visuals, here's a chart.
Mm.
See the chart?
This is from the 7th, by the way.
Yeah, this is from the 7th. So this is relatively four days ago.
Okay.
So what does this tell us? In China, the number of new corona cases is tapering off.
Mm.
See the orange curve?
No.
It's a distinct trend now. There are many speculations as to why it's tapering. The quarantines may be working. The virus may have already gotten to the most vulnerable individuals. And long story short, the death rate is 3.4%. And if you look at that compared to other epidemics, which they just announced this afternoon, this is a pandemic. And that's not a scary word. That just means that in majority of the continents, the virus has been noted.
Yeah, there's shit going on.
Yeah.
Sounds pretty scary.
It sounds scary. However, if you look at the percentages of death and the percentage of recovered individuals, it's not quite as scary as everybody's making out.
Well, I recommend you go buy a bunch of toilet paper for no reason.
Sure, absolutely. And cover yourself in
it. Everybody should just go buy toilet paper.
Yeah, just get toilet paper.
What the frick is
that?
You almost said it.
I know.
Yeah, I don't know.
You want more from this one?
Yeah.
Let's go down to the mortality rate. All right, if you'll notice the mortality rate, if somebody's 80 plus, it's 14.8%.
Yeah.
That's where the highest mortality rate is. And it declines as age gets younger, meaning that anybody younger than 50, which I still am, but only by a few months.
There was some speculation.
Yeah, there was some speculation as to my age. But if you're younger than 50, your mortality rate is significantly low.
Okay, from what 0.4. I understand, may I ask a question?
Yes.
Go on then.
The babies are the carriers, but they don't carry the symptoms. Is that the truth?
I have read that. I haven't seen reputable sources
so you
to back that
up. Spray bleach on your babies.
No.
The lady in Memphis.
Oh, well, spray it.
That's Memphis for you.
Yeah. Here's the thing. If you're younger than 70 years old, chances of you dying from coronavirus are relatively slim. And, you know, 8% if you're set, you know, if you make it to, if I make it to 70, I'm considered anything above that bonus territory. So, you know, though, especially the way I live. Not that I'm being insensitive to anybody over 70. I'm just saying, you know, you're on your way down the hill.
I heard you say you old effers earlier.
I'm 61.
Like, you old, old effers.
Yeah, dude, I heard, that's what I heard.
I'm insensitive. Things are a little shaky
in the coronavirus world. What am I at? 60 to 69.
Stephanie Bramlett says she has plungers.
3.6%.
I'm like the 0.2%.
What are you, 11?
I'm at the 0.4 percentile. That's where
too.
I'm at.
I'll admit it.
Anyway, stay safe.
Doubled up.
Yeah, here's the thing. I mean, you know, a lot of people who contract it actually don't even experience symptoms at all.
Yeah.
They don't know they have it.
They just
been tested. No.
That means these percentages are high, too, because they don't know about those cases.
Right, right. Absolutely. Because we don't even know about the total number of cases.
Right.
So it's, I'm not saying it's media. I'm not saying it's politicians. I'm not saying whatever. But for you to hold up in your house and buy 1,000 rolls of toilet paper is stupid. We are living our lives. Let's get out and live them and enjoy them. We're not promised tomorrow anyway.
What is the opinion of your nurse wife?
My nurse wife, it's kind of funny. Last week, I mentioned this on the show. Last week, she's like, I keep asking her, are they having any conversations at the hospital about it? She's like, no. But we're not buying this anymore because it was processed in China.
You mean like chicken?
We've used the same brand of bologna because my daughter loves it for years. And since she had teeth, since she grew her teeth in.
Is that Oscar Mayer?
No, I'm not going to cook. Guavi. Is what it was.
Was
it's a chicken bologna. So it's a little healthier than regular pork bologna, I guess. And week was the first time that we bought another bologna in 13 years.
Well, it last that
didn't
long.
Didn't taste it good, did it?
It didn't taste as good.
No,
it didn't have that. It didn't have that COVID-19.
That's that's what makes it taste good.
Yeah, that COVID-19.
You fry it up anyway. It gets rid of that shit.
Throw some cheese on it.
That's right.
Yep. Right next to the
viruses. You just fry it up.
Some spicy mustard to kill anything.
Yeah. I've been here way too long, so.
Fried spam.
But, you know, but the point being, we're about to make a lot of fun. We're going to poke a lot of jokes at this. It's your chances of dying in a car accident are greater than they are from dying from the coronavirus.
Mm.
So, okay. Anyway, moving on. The funny side of the coronavirus.
Or not dying at all. That'd be kind of
touching
cool.
That llama, you could probably.
You could probably, yes.
Get worse diseases. I found it in the Thai parking lot.
All right, so do you have these videos?
I have them. I don't know if you want to just talk about it.
All right, so cool thing about tragedy in the world is it always spawns a lot of humor, at least in my household.
Sick-minded individuals. Like
yeah, there's some sick people out there like me.
And everybody
who
watching
poke fun
show.
At things.
Well, and, hello, welcome.
How's it going? That's a swell beard you have, sir.
Yeah.
He said that's a swell beard.
So here are some parodies that people have written based on the coronavirus, which we think are pretty funny.
Yeah, go on then.
So hi, everyone. I'm Kathy.
Turn it off.
Started,
can you turn it up?
No, Red needs to turn it up.
Yeah, it's not me. It's good.
Mark has Red to turn up.
The Lord of the show ends.
Please.
And your mic's on.
They're live.
What's he saying?
Hello?
We're wanting to hear the this though.
Yes.
That's what she said.
Here you go. That's right. He turned it down.
It's like karaoke.
Did you turn it down or shoot? It's too small.
Sanitize.
That's enough of that one. Let's move on to the next one. So, you know, tragedy spawns creativity sometimes. Let's, let's check out this one, too. James Chambers. Hey, James, what's up?
Bob Bounce, watch.
We're trying.
We're trying.
The man with the buttons.
Yeah, we're not.
Hello, virus from Wuhan. Another problem's here again. Because you see the contagion creeping, and the virus is indeed spreading. And the memory of SARS planted in my brain still remains. We stand and fight the virus. We hear of theories how it grew. From snakes and bats became a flu, passing the sickness from man to man. Now it's growing, getting out of hand. It's a virus that has traveled near and far. Virus from Wuhan.
I'm drinking High Noon, sweetie.
Sam and Jerry Lee.
Yeah, let's turn that off, John.
Yeah,
it's terrible.
Should we
fire John?
Maybe. We're having
technical difficulties.
Yeah, something's interfering on the Wi-Fi. Right?
Yeah.
Damn,
so, if
you're wired in, you don't
concerned
need
about what's being canceled as a result of the coronavirus. This is,
we're gonna have it.
You can go to the Corona calendar.
What?
There is a Corona calendar out there now.
That's on screen, John. Just so
yeah,
know.
No,
yeah.
That's all. Like it's.
That's all you can do. So if you're looking for a particular event and you want to see if it's still open to attend,
go to our website.
Go to this website.
What's it called?
Is it canceled yet?
Is it canceled yet?
Is there a question mark
com.
In that?
No.
Generally
no question. No, there's
yes,
not.
Yes, there is up top.
Yeah, but not on website.
Not in the punctual. Not in the URL.
Look at the number of entries.
Ooh.
So, yeah,
two.
It's a lot.
Wait, 11, 12, 14.
Yeah.
27, 30, 32.
The Boston Marathon, no change.
Getting a seizure.
Not all of this is canceled.
Oh, yay. Coachella's still going. Woo.
Clorox iConnect. All right, so you have the one chemical that will kill anything.
And
you postpone it. It's like, no, let's not do this.
Well, there's your last one.
They weren't bringing it.
World Series of Poker, no change. Yeah, they don't care.
Hell no, they already had Corona.
Those guys are licking their hands while they're playing, shuffling the cards.
Right.
Yeah, but Walmart SparkCon's still on.
So I have a little trivia, and I'm not saying I know the answer, but I'm asking.
Okay.
I heard it this morning or yesterday morning at the morning meeting.
Yeah.
What created the Corona? The coronavirus. What created
it? Jumped from animals, didn't it?
Yes, it was an animal. And
bat.
It was, no.
No.
Bat
monkey.
Shit.
No. See, I told you the name of the animal, but it's like a. It's an Asian.
Well, how do you say it?
Like
then?
Almost dragon-looking.
Oh,
with
lizard
claws
thing.
And has the scales on
Gila
it.
Gila monster.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Penguin.
Come on.
It was a penguin.
No penguin. A pangolin is not a penguin.
There's no penguins in China.
It's almost like a dragon.
They're in the Arctic.
It's an anteater, but it's really cute. Thank you, Steve. Penguins are in the Arctic. It's scaled, and they ate it, and that's how it's treated. Thank you.
Can we post a picture of the penguin?
Yes. Do you have a penguin?
No. Okay.
All right. Well,
we're going to try that next week.
All right. Well, anyway.
Yeah. We'll try it.
Well, according to James Chambers, he says COVID-19, coronavirus, Wuhan flu, kung fu flu. I threw that in. He says, oh, no, look out. Racist comment is, he says, is a ploy. He's saying it's all a ploy. No worse than the common flu. Please stop the hysteria. It is the common cold.
Okay.
Says, we the people are being played.
What if?
We'd love to hear your comments on that and whether you think we're being played or not.
Can we shout out from the audience?
Until you get it. Yes, yeah, shout it out. Lee, what you got? What you
Wash
got?
Your hands.
Wash your hands.
And other things.
Mm-hmm.
What if?
Wash your ding ding, too.
That's the most attention I've had in 10 years.
That's funny.
That's good stuff.
And if employee's not available, wash your own.
That's right. Yeah. There's a sign in this bathroom that says that.
So we do have a couple of news stories that aren't related to coronavirus.
Look at the scam call center
owner in custody after BBC investigation. So if you ever got a scam call from India that said this particular call center was busted, they were the ones that were calling and saying, hey, they put a virus on a computer and they would try to get little old people to allow them to remotely log into their computer and they'd steal their information.
As little as a week ago, it happened here in Wilmington.
Did it really?
Yes.
So this call center in India got busted.
Of course they did.
What's going on?
Hi, hon.
Change from up front.
Oh, okay.
Nice. A penny? Nice.
Yeah, the llama.
It was a few. It was doesn't matter. Any, thought every I'd ask. Penny
every
counts.
Every little bit helps.
I was just asking how much it was. It's
none of your business.
It was like 40 cents, okay?
None of your business, man.
Looked like a... Yeah. Not that.
No domestic violence on the show. What are we talking about?
This is our lives. All right, this is how we interact.
So, you know, if you've ever got a scam call that you knew was a scam caller and you was like, man, I wish these guys would get their ass busted or something happened, guess what? There is some slight bit of justice
fantastic.
In the world, and these guys got busted.
Yep.
Yep.
They called me, I'm telling you that.
Oh, yeah, we had it on the show. Remember?
Yeah, we've called them back.
Yeah, I had Social Security call me this week.
Nice.
They're going to take me to jail.
They should.
And it was a Jamaican lady, so I believed it.
Mark Hines says he's not going to his proctologist because he licks his glove.
What are you doing licking gloves?
That's pretty nasty.
To keep your immunity up.
Yeah, that's right. Build that immunity.
Well, my proctologist said, I asked him, where should I put my clothes? And he goes, over there next to mine. I thought that was a bit of a problem. I thought that was going to be a bit scary when that.
Bazinga. So,
that was a little shaky. It was a good day, though.
All right, how many dog owners we have in the audience? Any dog lovers? Any dog lovers?
Dog lovers. Dog lovers.
Well, this dog finds and guards the family's bread whenever they leave the house. She thinks it's the most important thing because we use it so often.
Well, isn't it?
It is pretty important. Bread's important. You know, I'm from Georgia, and anytime it snowed in Georgia, there'd be a run, like the toilet paper run.
That's
now, there'd
right.
be a run on bread and milk.
Yeah.
Because everybody was going to make
milk sandwiches.
I'm from
Michigan. That was beer.
Yes.
They get beer. Alcohol.
Yeah.
So look at this dog guarding this bread.
Aww.
He's like, oh, you ain't getting this bread.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
Can the owners get
the
bread?
So what if the virus was an Amazon thing to make people order stuff and not leave the house?
That's a
they
conspiracy
do that
that's kind of stupid, but okay.
Look at all the bread.
Yeah.
There is video of this
Dog?
We don't. The video wasn't worth it.
Gotcha.
Yeah, so there's the puppy guarding the bread, which
I
is cute.
What's
what
the
a
dog's
sweet
name?
Dolly dog.
Yeast.
Why is the bread on the floor?
Easier for him to guard, I guess.
Yeah.
Oh, nice muffins.
Yeah, look at that.
That's what he said.
Jakey, his name's Jakey.
Jakey, eat on the bread.
I am not messing with Jakey, I'll tell you that.
If the family is out of bread, he moves on to guarding the butter, apparently.
He is so smart.
So, yeah.
Bubbles,
I love him.
Bubbles?
Bubbles!
Bubbles!
Good
one.
Sorry,
good
one. Did that.
The bubble man.
There you go.
The bubble man, dude.
So, wild video. Have anybody here ever driven through Atlanta?
Yeah. I used to live there.
Nobody drives through Atlanta.
I used to
they
live
go stop in Atlanta.
Yeah. 285, a lot of people think that's the way to officially get around Atlanta? No, it's not how it works. No. Check out this video of these guys doing donuts on I-285.
Oh, nice. Let's see if we can get it to
blow. Oh, there's the bubbles there.
Bubbles right in the middle for no reason.
That's the other bubble. That's the other bubble.
They've been doing it on 392 or whatever.
Look at this video of a stunt
have you really?
On I-285 that put drivers in danger. Street racers shut down the
airport. The runway's going above them.
Do this.
That's Clayton County, so that's airport, right?
It's like the Bend Airport. Is that Fast and Furious? Channel 2's Tom Jones, live in Clayton County.
Some kid with a Honda Accord with a doo-doo package on.
Yeah,
kind of
like that too.
Or it's just a guy with a trombone going.
On the back of the scooter.
On the back of the scooter.
Smoke and seals from the tunnel here, making it difficult. A lot of drivers didn't know what was going on. I talked to one couple, said they were traveling down this road, the highway at 75 miles per hour, and then had to come to a sudden standstill.
With my jacked up Camaro, my rocker,
this couple couldn't believe what they saw as they approached the 285 airport runway tunnel tonight around 11. Shut down eastbound traffic.
I'll tell you, I was riding under the hood the other day, and you know, if you don't know me, I live in Drift Hood. Which is a neighborhood here in Walton County. And I was coming out, and a kid had the doo-doo package on his car, and he was coming back. And I thought I was getting shot at. Because it's going, pap, 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 and I'm reaching to grab. I'm like, whoa, dude. And my wife grabs the steering wheel. She's like, what are you doing? I'm like,
She's like,
no, it's a kid with the doo-doo package on his car.
Yeah, it is terrible.
Yes.
Idiotic.
I can't imagine that you can hear anything or, like, but.
Yeah.
I'm not one to talk. We have loud mufflers.
No, but you know what we did? We'd buy pickup trucks when I was in high school and lower them to the ground.
Hell yeah.
And that's right. That's what I'm talking about.
Then you can't put anything in it.
And that was back when they started doing the subwoofers and everything. You'd throw them in the back.
Yeah.
And you'd have speakers all over the place and it'd rattle the screws out of the tailgate.
We had ours
jacked
up in the back. You know, we had the SS Chevelles
We didn't have cars in my day.
Yeah, that's right. You had a horse and buggy.
Yeah,
I used to jack them some bitches up.
Yeah, swear to God, I thought it was Amish.
So, there you go. Here's some tips for keeping your kids safe.
Oh, really?
This is from a Memphis news station.
Beat them a lot?
Yeah.
That's great.
This is
we need sound with this.
Fantastic.
I'll turn it. It's up all the way on sound. The sound was pretty low on that.
Red, turn this down.
No. On the video.
So let's just look in the background since we can't hear the sound what you'll notice is.
Why is it not?
I don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
Technical difficulties, ladies and gents.
We don't.
We're having problems tonight.
But, you'll notice in the background after she talks. I can't even imagine what you're saying. Hell no. And my kids don't get in trouble. But after
it'd
she gets done, wait till you see the father look at it looks like a Clorox bleach spray in his hand. And he's spraying his child in the face with.
And this one's like, hey, my baby ain't getting no coronavirus up in here. Look at this.
I'm
gonna scrub it off.
Look at that.
Oh my.
You got some Dollar General bags.
That'll do it.
That's my favorite.
That is, and we got a steal of that here. Yeah.
Should have totally came out like that.
Just Dollar General did that for all that, I think. That is terrific. Yeah. All right, so.
Hey, look, we're back.
Here we are back. So, I'm going to let Paul talk to you about this Irish name challenge thing.
Well, it's not that hard.
Well, tell them about it. Tell the audience about it. It's not that hard.
Well, it's St. Patrick's is coming up, so I thought it might be an idea.
And then St. Patrick's for those of you that aren't Irish.
St. Patrick's Day, whatever.
Translation Day.
Yes, exactly.
There's a few Irish names that are interesting, and one of them is a pretty famous actress, right? So I thought it might be an idea to have it, you know, where we put them up on the screen, which you can almost see, and then how do you pronounce it, and is it a girl or a boy?
Black.
Okay. Blathnad.
Blathnad. So the first one, there's sheets around with the names on them there. Blatantly. If you wanted to play. If you want one to.
Yeah, there's some sheets up there that have them on there for you guys playing it here. Right.
Maybe,
locally.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Some sheets have them, some don't.
Yeah.
Please add your comments to what you can
just
play.
Just keep sharing them till you find them.
Yeah.
Platinum. That's a boy. That's a boy. Black nut. God bless you.
I used to be up on my kill, but I can't. I'm at a loss right now.
How do you say it?
I'm not saying until the next screen comes up.
All right. Blotting.
Explain it.
Blotting? Yeah.
I do know them.
Blotting.
Because I wrote them.
And it's a girl's name.
It's Blotting. That's right.
Yeah.
Oh, so
it's called Blotting. So. So the spelling out of it is B-L-A-T-H-N-A-I-T.
Yeah, it's right there on the screen.
Well, they can't see that. See, we can't.
They can't?
No, where are they going to see it? In the ceiling?
Laugh, Ned.
I thought you said that they were on the sheets.
They are on the sheets. Some of the sheets.
Blatnid.
Blatnid.
How do you say it?
All right, let's go on to the next one. This is starting to get boring. Blatnid.
Blatnid. Just yeah.
Let's go to the next one. What you got?
Sunday Bush.
Sad Hoop.
Sad.
It's S-A-D-H-B-H. S-A-D-H.
Can you buy a vowel?
That's a lot of consonants.
You need to if you don't speak English. Sad.
Yeah.
Sad. It's hard, isn't it? Isn't that hard?
Sad. It's a boy's name.
S-A-D-H-B-H.
I'm calling
it. Says girl.
Girl or boy. I said it's a boy.
Well, if you're playing at home, you could play at home, see?
All right, what do you
Because you can see it on the screen at home.
Yeah, these 14 people watching at home aren't playing. So
that's, if you bring that up,
and I think
away.
Seven of them are here.
Eight.
There you go.
Wait, wait a minute.
Steve. It's a girl's name.
Yeah,
Jeff.
Steve. And it's a girl?
It's pronounced Kevin.
You go on A B C D E
Steve S E E V is how it's
Oh you can't read this Steve. Anyway, brother, I'm telling you.
I got this wound and it's Steve.
Steve.
Steve, girl.
Steve, all right, let's move on to the next one. Oh, snap.
Roderick.
Roderick.
Road rage.
Roderick.
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 Road rash.
Road rash.
Road rash.
Bubbles.
Bubbles, yes. Bubbles.
Ah, this is one of the easier ones,
when
actually.
When all else fails, bubbles.
Roderick.
Oh, okay.
And it's a
so
boy.
So the D-H-R-I is, you know, not.
Silent?
Actually, the A-I-D-R. Actually, the
A-I-D-H
is silent.
Then why
okay.
put it in there?
Rory?
Yeah, it's Rory.
It's Rory. Rory. Okay, yeah. I called the boy, yeah.
You did.
It's Rory. Yes.
You read way too many letters.
Because the hard R.
You could just say wrong.
Hard R, that's what she said. So, well, she got a hard R.
So this one looks like
that's right.
Thank Kiomi, you, right?
Thanks for noticing.
Nice.
Koi-mi.
Thanks.
This yes. one looks like Koi-mi.
Koi-mi.
Koi-otis.
Koi-otis?
So, just so you know,
oh,
a C at the beginning of the word is a hard C, by the way.
That's just hard. Hard C, that's right, yes. That's what she said.
So it's actually Jesus.
Kimmy.
My last girl.
It's a girl.
No. MH is boys? Not correct.
I didn't.
Chloe. Comey. Comey.
Oh, wait, hold on.
I know
some
this
of it's coming back to
James
me.
James Comey.
It's called
Kim. Kim.
Kim.
Kim?
Kim.
No.
Oh, come
Kim.
On.
No, it's Keith.
Know.
It's Keith.
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 Yeah, that's how it's pronounced. Keith.
Oh,
hey, it's pronounced Keith. Like,
Keith.
Yeah.
Keith's not on.
Well, exactly, because that's the first, the top part.
C-A-O-I-M-H-E.
Girl. If you're just joining us, we are these are actual Celtic Irish. Names, Irish Celt names, and we're trying to figure out the pronunciation since St. Patty's Day is coming up.
Yeah, if you're just joining us.
Donna. Donna.
Donna.
It's girl. Donna.
Donna. Donna.
That's actually pretty close.
Don't you?
Don't you? Oh, nice. You got
it.
Steve.
Yeah,
nice.
Good job, Steve, man.
Good job.
Don't you? Nice.
All right.
That's pretty good.
Scorsese.
Scorsese.
Martin.
Sassy.
Needs Martin.
It's Cersei.
Martin.
Yeah, there's an actress. This is an easy one. This is an easy one because there's an actress.
The girl that was in labor.
There is no Kaiser Sorcy.
Sarah. Sarah.
Sarah.
Sarah.
Sarah.
Sarah.
There you go. Sorcia.
Sorcia.
Sorcia. Sorcia. Catherine O'Sullivan should
That's
be
fun.
Getting all these.
That was fun.
She's in Ireland, I think.
Yeah, is that last one?
Well, they have internet there.
Okay. All
right.
Concubar.
Concubar is a good
one. I've read about them in the Bible.
That sounds Muslim.
So a whole group of concubars.
Aren't they in Japan? And
they found Jesus, and they got saved, and they stopped concubaring.
Gerald.
Yes, they got right.
Japanese, aren't they?
Do what?
The Japanese.
Concubines?
Yeah.
You should do a whole Bible translation segment.
No, that's so wrong. I'm ordained.
Now it's wrong after you said concubine.
No, it was funny while I was doing it.
Okay.
Minute,
yeah. Connor.
There, Connor.
Why don't we just call him Connor?
Duh.
Connor. Short.
Concubar.
Connor.
That's a good one. Funnier.
For Dorcha.
C-H is
bless you.
As well.
For Dorcha.
Oh, I see. You're not letting the audience type in the answer.
You're doing fine. They're not doing anything anyway. Keep going.
That's irrelevant.
Useless.
Yeah. All right. So.
Freaking useless.
Language.
Fakna.
This one you'll like.
Fakna.
I'm offended. See, you're Fakna.
It's not like a partner, but it's a Fakna.
This is like my Fakna donuts.
Yeah.
Or what's it called?
What?
Dumplings.
What's it called? Dumplings.
Donuts. My Fakna dumplings.
Yeah. Donuts. Wrong.
You should go on a diet. Apparently you're Fakna.
Keith.
No.
Fachina.
Actually, it is.
Fachina.
Fachina.
Fakna.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Fakna?
There goes another one. Yeah.
Is it Fakna?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Fakna. What I said.
It's Foggy Night.
That's what I said. I said Fakna earlier.
That means dark, by the way.
Sounds like a swear.
How many of these do we have?
84.
84? It's
starting to get boring.
No.
42 minutes.
Justin Bieber.
42.
Bieber.
That's why I brought that one up, because it's Bieber.
Bieber.
That's the answer to the universe, 42.
Yeah.
Bieber.
Of course it is.
Yeah.
Here's
see?
The bonus.
All right, oh, wait, bonus.
Wait,
we get the
bonus. Wait, bubbles first.
Bubbles.
Oh. Bubbles.
Say, show it. Put this one up because it's got SEO.
Say, show it.
See that for the SEO part.
Yeah, SEO. CEO Sam.
CEO Sam and then. These are difficult.
That's the new virus next time.
That's it. That's right. CSM at 19.
Is it a girl or a boy? No, is it a girl or a boy?
Buy toilet paper now.
Is it a girl or a boy?
It's a girl.
It's a girl.
Yes.
Definitely.
Show shaven.
Oh,
she's show shaven.
Yes. So shaven. Jesus.
She's so shaven.
So shaven.
Yes.
No.
It's like a Hitler mustache.
All the Irish people watching this are going to be upset.
Both of them.
You watch the comments on the replay. I'm telling you.
All right, I'm not going to watch. I don't watch this show. It's
going to be a So Sheevan day. Is what it's going to be.
This show's terrible. I don't watch it.
So Sheevan.
So if you think those names are all effed up.
We thought they were normal.
They're actual names of towns
in
Ireland.
Well, good segue, man.
Yeah, thank you. I'd finish it if you'd shut up.
Why did both of these? So come on.
So some of the names in Ireland of towns are all.
I've been to all of them.
This is where Paul's from. He's from Bastard Town.
No, I'm from Belfaster Town.
Yeah, Belfaster Town.
Billy Joel sing a song?
He did sing a song. It's about Bastard Town.
He's in the private army.
Yes, he was.
Shouldn't you want to move there just to say
was a Norman settlement, so it's French.
Yep.
It's nearby Whoretown and Heavenstown, which are two opposite ends of the spectrum, by the way. But the better whores were in Heaventown.
Yes. And
the high-paying hoes were in Heavenstown.
And where did the horse chief live?
Yeah.
It's always a hell of a Friday night.
In Bastard Town, yes.
It's a hell of a
Friday night. Well, it is a singular, Friday night. It's just a singular whore town. There's not multiple whores in it.
Yeah, there's a single hoe in the whore town.
Yeah.
And then all the grid whores were in Heavenstown.
Those the married whores?
Yes. Right, and then all their kids live in Bastard Town.
Exactly.
Yes.
That is the result of the whore town.
Exactly. All right, we got a few more. Welcome to Muff, Ireland.
No, wait.
Speaking of Shashivine, this is where she lives. in Muff, Ireland.
Yes.
Without her Muff.
We come to Muff.
I have not been to Muff.
Sorry.
I don't even know where that is.
I don't know where that is.
Oh, it's done again.
Knee deep. All right.
It's 50 kilometers.
It's not a sausage party, if that's what you're asking.
They technically sell Muff waiters.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
I have been to a lot of places in Donegal. Muff is not one of them.
Yeah. You've never been to Muff?
I have not, like Muff. I heard they cut the grass every week.
That's what Helen told me last week.
As soon as you come in there, there's a lawn.
What does the sign mean?
It means that, you know, it please means... be careful. Bring a carful to the Muff.
No,
yes, it's right next to Horse.
Somebody's messed with the sign, John. It says carefully.
The E and the Y.
They've been.
Please drive a car full of Muff to Muff Town.
And then we come to Muff. The L somebody has tampered with. As yes, well.
The speed limit is 50 kilometers, so nobody knows what speed that is.
No, I don't.
So I
operate in freedom units, and that's not freedom units. Look,
that's right.
That is not the unit that got us to the moon.
That is not the imperial pint traveling speed.
Right. So
anyway,
there you go.
How's the comments doing there? Somebody said
Frith is. She said she needs a bubble bath and lots of bubbles. After
I was a little creeped out until I remembered. I was like, Frith, that's too.
I'll come over with a sponge.
Oh Jesus.
Oh Lord.
Oh Jesus.
I thought you'd never been to Muff.
Something about Frith.
Okay.
Has he been here?
No. So he's been a crazy corner, I assure you.
No, I haven't been there either. No.
That's the next town in Ireland. All right, let's move on
to the
next
one.
This is not near as funny.
It's near Mullingar, but I've never been there.
It's not as funny.
I've been to Mullingar.
It's where your mom
not near as funny as this. There's Spunkane.
Yeah.
That's not that funny.
Right next to Spanking.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Huh?
What?
That's in Scotland, actually.
Right.
Spanking. What is that thing?
That's
a transatlantic cable.
The first thing they laid.
Yeah. You got Effin County. Effin in Limerick. County Limerick. They say County Limerick in Ireland instead of Limerick County. Like
I'm
we say.
Totally.
You're going to your Effin home when you live there.
Yeah, go to your
Effin totally
house.
From Effin County. Right.
Also bases, it, they also have places in Limerick County called Necker and Hospital.
Yeah.
Oh.
Wait. Is it Effin or I thought it was Fungin?
No, Effin's.
Okay, right. I thought the town was called
like Knickerbocker.
No.
Okay. All right.
No.
Yes, I think so. You got Blue Ball.
Announce that. Correct.
Blue Ball. There obviously is no hose in that town.
They're using the N-word.
Wait, I can't believe you put that racist shit on here, man.
Don't look at me. It's an upside.
All right. Knobber.
Yeah.
Knobber. Meath. A village, Knobber, is one of the favorites on Ireland's list of amusing place names.
And read the rest of it.
It's also the birthplace of a blind harpist.
Turlough O'Carlan.
So there's an image.
Turlough.
All right, moving on.
Oh, then there's this guy.
What's that going to do?
We're running out of time here.
We ran out of Irish towns there.
All right, so moving on to funniest vids this week. Our picks. A woman decided to put this is from the previous news story. A woman put this on her child to protect the kid from the virus.
Dollar General bags.
Thank you, Dollar
now,
General.
3 years from now, when this kid's about to graduate high school, what do you think is going to be in the yearbook?
I killed my mother.
I killed my mom. Or this picture, one or the other.
Oh.
And this picture. All right. Let's move on. Dang.
Treed well. Oh, another joke. Yes.
No.
Yes, please.
All right, watch this.
Oh, this is fantastic.
She's taking really good care of her kids.
Uh-huh.
All right.
Tag team. Yeah. Back again.
Let's jump in the puddle.
I see it's portrait.
Nope.
Portrait mode.
Boom.
Flail.
Oh, that was her head.
They flipped that.
They killed their mom right there.
Yeah.
Bless her heart. All right, let's move on. We're running out of time.
All right. Okay.
All right, we need sound for this.
Yeah. Well,
okay.
It's turned up.
Nice.
So, for those of you here that weren't able to watch that was a guy farting in the intercom at Walmart.
Yeah, nice.
Perfectly, by the way.
Is there a video?
Yeah. We're watching it. It's on the show.
That is.
Here, one more time. Yes.
And no trumpet involved.
So as we talked about earlier, you know, tragedy often brings some of the best humor out of people, or the worst, wherever you want to look at it.
Just look at my face.
So we've got some good memes here. When someone in a few months asks what killed everyone, and it shows a picture of, you remember the Bare Naked Ladies in that song they did? It's Chicken to China, the Chinese chicken.
That's what killed everybody.
That's the meme here.
That's it. Yeah,
and you guys that are watching at home, you know what we're seeing.
Yeah, it's a visual.
But I'm explaining it for the people here that are on ABC.
Yeah, there's a dog. All right.
Some people aren't shaking hands because of the coronavirus. I'm not shaking hands because everyone's out of toilet paper.
There you go. Amen.
Amen.
Oh,
shit. Right?
Amen. Oh, shit.
Yep. Ah. Speaking of TP, me trying to figure out how, you know, wash your hands translates to buy all the toilet paper.
I did. Yeah, that's me.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure that out. I don't
understand. What's happening?
I heard online that it was because they thought they had to be quarantined for 2 weeks or more.
Yeah.
Well, God forbid. Did you buy all the toilet paper?
What are you buying, one roll of toilet paper at a time?
How many rolls of toilet paper for 2 weeks?
Are you strictly, when you're quarantined, strictly eating burritos and,
baked beans and,
baking beans and burritos.
So, all right, let's go back. We're going back. We'll go back to this.
No, the network's delayed on...
Damn you, network delayed.
Yep.
Damn you.
I totally don't.
I thought you were wired in.
So, Bubbles.
Bubbles. Time.
All right.
Bubbles.
So, some of y'all went from DIY homemade natural all organic cleaning products to Clorox real fast. Just saying that.
I think the whole thing's a Clorox thing.
Oh, you organic mofos.
Just jump in the shower.
Jump in the shower. Look, I'm no expert with COVID-19, but this is the cure. And if you can't see this, it's actually a picture of the band, The Cure.
I saw that one. I liked it.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord, help me.
All right. So this baby kid is licking something.
That's awesome.
Oh, God.
You know that?
It's like a glass around a turnstile.
Y'all want to know something funny? That's exactly what I look like.
Redhead. Oh, that's great.
That's what I look like.
I think that is at the bank.
I don't know where he's at, but
he's tagged in NHL, so I'm thinking it's at a hockey game.
Even better. Is there more of these with the children? Because there's one where she's licking.
No, that's the only one.
I think there's only one more left.
So, and this next one's about hand sanitizer.
Oh, Lord.
Look, if you need it, I got the good Purell, $50 a gram.
Don't tell me. I got some in my purse now.
Mm-hmm. I will hook
you up. Babies.
That's right.
I will hook you right up.
Well, Matt's pretty clean, so you can use that.
Yeah, that'll be fine, I'm sure.
Yeah, and by the way, Tito's vodka doesn't have enough alcohol in it to clean your hands. You need Golden Grain or something like that if you're going to buy liquor.
What about Goose?
It has enough alcohol to make you not care.
That's true. That's true.
Clean your innards.
That will clean your innards. So.
That's a word I learned since I've been here. Innards.
We gonna wrap this sucker up or what?
Yeah.
We actually rushed through that. We got 2 minutes.
That was good. Oh, you see what you did?
You could read this language.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
So
let's do more. Do more, Tracy.
Yeah. Let's talk a little bit more about Bubbles.
Bubbles.
Oh, tiny llamas. So, Tracy.
We'll post the links.
Yes, we'll post the links here, but you can get that donations. I'm sure they're going to be all over 30A.
Yeah.
If you want to do something online, if you're out of town, if you know her from Kansas, or charity event, at Kelly Assist. Yay!
Billy Bannon's got paid this week. Look at
that's
it.
Right.
March 29th. We're at here in McTighe's.
Oh, sweet. All
right.
So like a street party.
Street party at McTighe's.
And here.
What date?
29th.
March 29th of March. Here at Red's Fueling Station and McTighe's. Just street party. Go back and forth. 12
what day
four.
Is that?
That is Sunday.
Sunday fun day.
And then there's a GoFundMe page. And the page that you set up, Kelly, is what?
Did I just hear that the fundraiser is here?
Yep.
Between here and there.
Yes.
Okay. It's in the parking lot.
You're welcome. We're doing
I offered, but I didn't hear anything back.
We're doing
We're
doing a dry brunch.
It's okay.
Yes.
GoFundMe.
I'll do it for money.
It's on my page.
You can wax my ass for $20 a pop.
What the hell are you talking about?
What? Who wouldn't pay $20 to wax my ass?
If it's done once,
I wouldn't.
There's no hair on his ass.
$20 to get in to see it.
There's all this stuff that you want to know.
But it's worth a shot.
I would pay $20 not to see that.
There you go.
Hey, so and if y'all get us $40 we'll already. Put on that script page and share it elsewhere.
That's actually a portion then.
That's right. That's right.
Listen, whatever raises the money, I don't care.
These jars are going to be all around town.
You know what? We all have our differences, believe it or not. But we take care of our own, and that's what this is about.
That's right. It's a great
community.
Yeah. She's going to need help. We don't get into
identity politics. We just get into being American.
Yeah, we just get into being good neighbors, and that's what this is about.
That's right.
Anyway. Hey guys, we hope you enjoy all 14 of you enjoyed the broadcast.
Oh, by the way, sorry, real quick, Derek Gossett's here because he said he was coming over tonight.
Yeah, and he said I have the corona. I
don't think he even exists. I think it's like a pseudonym.
I met him on the beach the other day.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, that's a made up thing.
So you got the corona as well.
You didn't take any photos, did you?
Hey, night guys.
So hey guys, thanks for joining in. We'll see you next week on the Nothing Scripted Show.
Be nice to your friends.
Love you.
And those that aren't.
Hey, bye.
All right, cut that shit off.
You can't.